Our Banking Below 30 investigation uncovered just how little money banks were lending to black and brown communities. And now the nation's most powerful banking regulator is weighing in, calling our findings very troubling. Here's David Schechter with an update.
At a congressional hearing on Wednesday, the chairman of the Federal Reserve Bank, Jerome Powell, who's America's most powerful banking regulator, took questions from lawmakers.
Thank you for your participation.
Including from Congressman Emanuel Cleaver from Kansas City. Cleaver's question was about the findings of WFAA's Banking Below 30 investigation, showing how some banks draw service area maps that cut out the largely black and Hispanic communities that live below Interstate 30.
And this TV station, WFAA, found that 20% of banks in Dallas County, that it drew maps that exclude all or parts of southern Dallas County.
Cleaver told Powell about the example of Interbank and the map it submitted to government regulators that shows where the bank intends to make its loans. While the law says these maps cannot discriminate based on income or race, Interbank's map showed coverage to all of Ellis County, Erath, Somerville, Hood, Parker, and Tarrant counties, but the map excluded the lower half of Dallas, where most of the residents are minorities. Our story reported that when government regulators looked at these maps and others like it, they found no evidence of discrimination. In fact, regulators are giving banks passing grades on their exams 98% of the time.
Well, thank you. And you or your staff brought this article to the attention of our staff, who brought it to my attention, and I've had a chance to look at it. And yeah, it's very troubling on its face, the article, and it just shows, we need real vigilance in making sure that banks honor their obligations to serve minority communities, low and moderate income communities, minority communities within their operating areas.
After our original story, Interbank updated its map. Now it encompasses the entirety of Dallas County. In a comment to WFAA, Interbank says the new map embraces our vision of serving all areas within our branch footprint, including minority and low to moderate income communities. Community leaders in Dallas hope exchanges like these will show top regulators like Powell how they are complicit in allowing banks to turn their backs on the minority community.
So that one got our attention, and we can't talk about individual institutions, of course, but we take this very seriously, and we appreciate your bringing it to our attention.
All right, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I yield back, Madam Chair.
In Dallas, I'm David Schechter reporting.